You would be forgiven if you forgot there is a race for president still underway. Despite a pandemic, voters in Wisconsin went to the polls this week. Bernie Sanders pulled out of the contest, ceding the Democratic nomination to Joe Biden. Let's talk about all of this with Dr. Stephen Menard Caliendo, who joins us on the phone. He is the Dean of the College of Arts and Sciences, Professor of Political Science at North Central College. Good morning. Thanks for being with us today. How are you doing?
Good morning, Sally. I'm great. Thanks for having me.
Let's first talk about Bernie Sanders dropping out. He suspended his campaign. He certainly did not give a full-throated endorsement to Biden, but said he would back him. What did you think about him pulling out this week?
It wasn't completely unexpected. I think as we moved through the primaries last month or so, it became clear that his path was narrower and narrower. And I thought the speech he gave was the tone was appropriate. It was, he's got a very difficult challenge. He has been criticizing Joe Biden for many months, and now he has to turn his support toward him, and he's got to get his supporters, many of whom are quite enthusiastic about his candidacy and his ideological positioning, over to supporting Joe Biden to help defeat Donald Trump in the fall. And so he understands this is a long process. It wasn't moving everybody in one speech. It was setting some groundwork for the months to come.
He also said he wanted his people to keep voting for him so he can amass more delegates. And speaking of the nominating conventions, how is all of this pandemic going to affect those conventions that we're supposed to be having this summer?
Well, it's already affected the Democratic National Convention in Milwaukee because it was supposed to happen in July, and it's now been pushed back until August. It's really important, the work that gets done at those meetings. I think, most of us think about them as the place where the presidential candidates for each party are nominated. And that's true, but we haven't had more than one ballot in many years at a convention. We know going in who the nominee will be. That's not the most important work that happens there. There's platform building. There's affinity group gatherings. For instance, the Republican women will meet, and the college Republicans will meet, the young Republicans will meet. And there's grooming for candidates down the road, congressional candidates, state and local candidates. It's important to have those meetings. Now, whether or not they can happen in person, I'm not sure. But Bernie Sanders wants to have enough people who believe the way he believes the Democratic Party should be moving at those meetings and having a say in all the work that gets done there.
Before we even get to the convention, to those meetings, we still have voting to do. Wisconsin still held their primary this week despite quite a battle in the courts to stop it by the governor there. How is this pandemic going to affect the rest of the election season?
It's going to be very difficult for states to hold in-person voting. Many of them have already made decisions to either solely vote by mail or to relax their absentee voting regulations so that anybody who wanted to vote by mail could do so. So I think we're going to see more of that. It's going to really decrease voter turnout if we're telling people you need to stay home and not go to work and avoid going to the grocery store, but go stand in line to vote, especially when at the top of the ticket, there's not a contest left. But these primaries are important because it's not just selecting delegates to the national conventions, but there's, as Illinoisans know, there's lots of ballots. There's lots of races down the ballot, and those are important elections that need to take place too. Campaigns that are relying on people showing up and casting ballots for their candidates.
All right, Dr. Caliendo, thanks for your time. We'll have you back, and we can talk again about what comes in November. Says we still got a big election coming up then, that this all leads
That's
to
right.
that. Dr. Caliendo, you can find out more on him if you head to northcentralcollege.edu. We appreciate your time. Dr. Stephen Menard Caliendo.